Hi, Melissa Berg here. Guess what? You want to learn how to paint this Baby Yoda, and I'm going to show you how. All you have to do is go to my Gumroad page and download two files. You'll find the link in the description below. The two files you need are the photo from the TV show The Mandalorian, which you can watch on Disney Plus, and the sketch that I created for you to follow if you don't want to draw your own. So, let's get started. So now that you have downloaded both the image and the sketch from my Gumroad page, you should have saved the sketch in your iCloud, Dropbox, or Google Drive. And the reason you want to do that is because the sketch has a transparent background, and the Photos app on your iPad, and I believe on your iPhone too, often puts a background into it, so then it'll suddenly have a white background, and then when you import it into your sketchbook, you can't take out the background. It won't be transparent anymore. So we want just the pencil lines and nothing else. So now let's open Sketchbook. Now, if you have never opened this before or haven't started anything, you will have a blank canvas here. I have the last thing I had open, which I don't want. So I am going to hit the little icon up here at the top left, choose gallery. I'm going to just save current sketch, and then I'm going to delete it if it's actually still there. Yeah. So just ignore that. Now, this will take you back to your project folders. I will hit the tutorials, and then I want to hit the plus sign at the bottom. Now we are going to open new from image. So choose that and hit browse. Now this is where you go to your, wherever you saved your sketch, which mine is in the iCloud drive. If you need to browse to something else, you just hit the back button until you get to it. And I put mine in artwork, and there he is. And now it opens. Now it's a fairly large file. I put it at 5400 by 5400 deep pixels. That's the way Sketchbook, how it creates the files, the sizes. It doesn't use inches or centimeters or anything. It, how I came to that size was it should be about 18 by 18 at 300 DPI, and I used Photoshop to find out how many pixels that would be. And I usually always work in that size. Usually the shortest will be 5400, and so for a standard 18 by 24 poster size, that's 300 DPI. I usually do 5400 by 7200, and I've never had a problem. You just want to make sure you have enough room on your iPad. So if you have a lot of videos or photos or games or music, you might need to remove some of that so you can work on a larger size sketch. So let's start here. I have Yoda, Baby Yoda. It's not actually Baby Yoda. I do know that, but we don't know who else he is. And you know, I don't think I remember ever hearing what kind of creature he actually is, or species or race or whatever they're called in Star Wars. So we just call him Baby Yoda. Now, if you haven't seen The Mandalorian, it's a pretty good show. The reason I picked Baby Yoda is because he's easy And he appears to be easy. I'm hoping he's easy to paint for all the beginners out there. He's cute without being cartoonish. And so we can still paint him in a very realistic style, which is kind of my style. My style is probably a more stylized realism, I guess you could say. If you look at any of my past projects on my YouTube channel, you can see that I like color, but I also like to try to make everything photo real. So yeah, you can decide what you call it. But my favorite artists that I often look to when I'm trying to get ideas or just for inspiration is like I really like Alphonse Mucha. Anything from Art Nouveau period. I like somebody more current is Stephanie Puman Law. I have all of her books just because I like to page through and look at these her style, and it often inspires my drawing for some reason. I don't know why. So a lot of times if you're stuck trying to find, you know, how to draw something or you don't know what to draw, go to Pinterest and look up fantasy art or portrait art or, you know, specific artists that you've always liked and just kind of immerse yourself in their drawings and their paintings and their illustrations. Look at comic books. There's some comic book artists out there that I really like too. Andy Braze is one of them. Ricardo something, I'd have to go look, but I really like his style. So anyway. Okay, so now what you can do is we need to bring up our reference picture. So I am going to bring up the doc, choose my photos, drag this across to the side. All the newer iPads should be able to do this now because they're all running the iOS 13. And I'm going to move it over just so I have more space for drawing. And we're going to pick the Yoda picture. And we can zoom in. And now we can see colors and details better. So then now on our painting here, first what we're going to do is we are going to add two layers. Actually, three layers we want. One, two, three. Hitting the plus button up there three times. And then I'm going to drag each one below the sketch. Now, next, you can choose the bottommost layer, and then we're going to go into our selection tools up here and choose the lasso. And now we are just going to carefully draw around our Yoda. It doesn't have to be perfect. We will fix that later. Make sure all of it is included. Now we are going to go to our palette, our color palette, and we're going to pick kind of a nice dark purple, kind of grapey or plum color right in here. Maybe it's also avocado. See where I have this settings. And I have one in here already, but if you want to save that color so you can use it again later, drag it from up here and put it into your palette. Now we are going to choose the paint bucket. And we're going to tap inside our selection, and that fills the whole thing. Now we're going to leave this selected, and we're going to go to the next layer up, and we're going to choose a new color. And this one will be kind of the medium blue-green that Yoda is. I already have one selected here, but you can see it's sort of in the minty green area, but then we also desaturate it, so we bring it over here a bit. And then you can drag that into your palettes to save it again. And now we are going to make sure you're on the second layer up from the bottom. And we are going to fill that one. Now we are going to go to one more. And we are going to do a slightly lighter, more kind of yellowy green tone. So we're going to, I have one picked already because I was checking this out earlier. And you can see here, we move the green up towards the yellow a tiny bit, And then we want it lighter, but we don't want it super bright, so we desaturate it a bit. And then you can drag that into your palettes. So you can use it again, and we will. And then make sure your paint bucket is chosen and that you're on the third empty layer up here. And we're going to hit fill. And then we're done with that. And now we're going to take off the selection. And now we're ready for the next step, which is erasing. Now we're going to use my favorite erasing brush. We don't want a solid erase all of it. We want it to have kind of a washy watercolor effect. So choose this brush. If it's not in your, I don't remember if it's in your default brush settings here. So it is called the textured eraser, and you can find it in here. And then go to advanced settings, and we're going to set the pressure. You don't need the light pressure size up too high. You want it pretty low, but it doesn't need to be all the way at the bottom. We'll adjust this as you continue. And the size with heavy pressure will be changing as you paint. Same thing, opacity, you want it kind of halfway, probably 3/4 of the way up here. Or I should say 1/4 of the way up here, sorry. And then the stamp is fine. And the nib, you want the hardness all the way down, but this is your texture. We're not going to have a shape on it, but the texture is all the way at the bottom. So if this is not a default brush setting, you can set that. Scale, brightness, all that should be just the defaults. You shouldn't have to change anything else. Now you're going to turn off the topmost light green layer, and we're only going to be working with that medium tone green layer to start with. So now what we're going to be erasing out are where it's going to be darkest, because whatever you're erasing, it's going to make this purple show through. So you can change the angle, whatever is comfortable for you. I think I will start with his mouth. He's even got little teeth in there. So cute. Alright. See, we just start erasing that right out. You need to make it smaller. Don't worry about your lines. Don't be too sloppy. But it doesn't have to be perfect either. So now we're just going to pretty much follow the shapes that you see. I call these my guidelines so that the shapes can be accurate. Now, if any of these moments seem like they're getting too long, I will probably speed up this portion of the drawing, but that doesn't mean you have to try to keep up with it. You can just watch what I do and then pause and finish it yourself on your own, at your own level, at your own speed, because obviously I'm not going to be super fast either, but for the sake of time for the video, I might speed up some of this. Now if you're feeling intimidated by this a little bit, don't. Just, this is teaching you how to see. A big part of drawing, probably 80% of drawing, is learning to see correctly. And you're not seeing, you know, when you just look at something, you see, okay, grass, green, trees, you know, brown trunk, you know, snow is white. Well, not really. If you really start looking at it, look at it closely, blur your eyes a little bit. What colors do you actually see? The shadows in snow, are, especially on a sunny day, are like a bright blue, a bright like cobalt blue. Trees are never just have brown trunks. There's all sorts of different colors going on in there. Now, if you can't get close enough in your photo over here, a nice thing is go to the edit And now it's changed a little bit, so I have to remember how to do it quickly. I believe it's, yeah, down here. And then change the size, so you go like that and hit done. And now you can zoom in even more. But you notice all these tiny shapes, which I have already kind of shown you in the sketch here by outlining them here. Those are your guides to also keep you like, okay, where am I here on this painting? Where is this area? This is here. But start to actually see these shapes on your own. So I'm using different pressure in these different shapes, depending on how dark it is. And I'm just erasing out as much as I feel I need to. Now, if you make a mistake, don't worry about it. You can fix it later by either blending it or, you know, just going back in there with the color of this green. That's why you wanted to save it in your palettes, just in case you needed to use it again. Undo as often as you need to. If you didn't like a shape or a line you just did, or if it's in the wrong spot, go ahead and undo. This is the other thing I like about Sketchbook. It does have a limit on how many undos you can go, but it's pretty large. I don't even know what it is. I've always had to test its limits by going, can I keep going? I did something wrong several brush strokes ago. How far will it let me? I'm always kind of surprised. That's why I like this program. You can do a lot for how simple and free it is. Now, the Apple Pencil, I would really advise getting that. I always struggled with painting on an iPad with anything else, and then when I finally was able to get a Pro, back when you could only use it on a Pro, and get the pencil, I was just blown away by how nice and natural it feels. Obviously, we're running out of space where Yoda's ear is. We're not able to zoom in there. So if you've done what I've done and zoomed in on Yoda's picture here, so you go to the edit and you hit revert. Revert to original. And then you're back to the original size. It always keeps that there. It's always, you're never stuck like, oh, it saved it that way. I'll never get it back. It will always be there. So I'm just going to continue erasing away this middle green layer here. I'm going to speed up the video just to save some time. You can watch the rest of it and then pause it and continue with your painting until we get to the next section. I'll see you then. This is the end of part one of the Painting Baby Yoda tutorial. Join me for part two. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of the next tutorials that I create. Thanks for watching!